Hey everyone, and welcome back to another podcast, Photography Made Easy. And this podcast, and all of our podcasts, our number one goal is to give you something that you can learn from in under 10 minutes. And with that being said, Joe, how's it going? And welcome aboard.
Thank you, Scott. And I'm very proud to be a part of these podcasts that you've started. I think people are learning from it, and I think it's a good vehicle.
Yeah, definitely. I got to be honest. I know you have, and I have as well. We've received emails, and actually, that's where tonight's, next question is going to come from. It actually was emailed to me, but there's been some, comments on the blog, and emails have come from me to you, and it's really just a great way to interact with people and see where they're at. But this question here, I'm going to talk about tonight, is going to be about lighting, and there's a reason why we're going to talk about this. Number one, a question came in, but also because Joe and I have been working on a project that we're going to be announcing here pretty soon, and it's going to pertain to lighting. So with that being said, let's get on to the question, because again, we only have about 10 minutes because we like to keep these under 10 minutes so you guys can learn something and get moving. So here we go. It came in from Ron Ballard. Thanks, Ron, for emailing this question to me. But here it is. It says, hi, Scott. Enjoy the great information on your podcast and especially looking forward to the upcoming podcast on studio lighting. If you are covering the always-on lighting setups, and what he means there is continuous lighting, that he means all the light stays on all the time, as compared to studio flash, I hope you will be able to cover the lamps. I'm hearing about the fluorescent lights, the spiral ones, now available for studio lights. I'm hoping you can cover this area sometime in the near future, maybe in your next podcast. Keep up the great work, Ron. Ron, great question, and I'm glad you asked it because I do have an opinion on these, and I know Joe does as well. And the thing is that kind of irritates me is you go to eBay and you look up lighting. And if you're a new photographer or even someone that's just looking to upgrade your lighting and you don't know a lot about the lighting, you go on there and you're going to basically see a lot of things on there that are probably a piece of junk. And I mean, Joe, is that right?
You said it very kindly.
I mean, you go there and you see all this stuff on there and they want to sell you these big kits that got like five lights and all this. And it's just, it's crap. And I can't say it any nicer than that. It's just crap. And a lot of times, I mean, there's some good stuff on there, don't get me wrong. But, to say that you're going to use this stuff in a professional, photography studio, it's probably, not representing, the actual equipment really that well, because the equipment that he's talking about, I personally have looked into, and I looked into it for video. I see these continuous lights being used for video, and they work really good for video. But for flash photography, I would say no. And there's some reasons that I don't like them, because number one, it's continuous, it's on all the time. Yes, the newer lights don't get as hot, but they still do. And the other thing is they can break. And I know, Joe, you had an incident just recently that was, about it breaking. Why don't you explain that a little bit?
Well, these are the CFL types, this little spiral things that you put in all your lamps at home, and you're supposed to be echo and green. And one of mine, I use them for still life, because I'll do tabletop type, and I don't want to use my flash for those things. And one was lying on the floor, and it broke. So I probably put a good amount of mercury in the air.
Naughty, naughty, naughty. The one thing I do want to bring up, though, Joe, because I know that we've talked about it, and I mean, you're the expert on the lighting, and I know very little compared to what you know. But what you did say, and you brought up a good point when we were talking about this off the air, was basically that you have a lower wattage, so you're going to have to basically shoot at higher shutter speeds. Is this correct?
Yeah, they come, they're sold like 23 to 26 watts, which is a CFL language, and they say it represents 150 watt tungsten bulb.
Okay. And everybody, I think, can relate to the tungsten, where you get that warm, yellowy, look on your pictures. That's pretty much the tungsten. And, the newer lights, they have all different ones that are, daylight balanced, and they're a little more of the blue side. And, so you have all different kinds of lighting out there. The other thing is, too, Joe, I mean, talk a little bit about mixing the lights.
Well, if you get one that's, we'll go into Kelvin a little bit, but daylight is 5,000, and so is, the sun or the flash strobes. But these bulbs could be 5,000 or 6,000. And you don't want to mix them if you had one as a main light on the face and one was the key or the fill. Now you've got both sides of somebody's cheek with a different color temperature, and how do you play with that in Photoshop? It's a little more work than you need if you had the right rating to begin with, and flash is one of the ones that balances out with daylight the best.
Yeah, and that's going to be a white balance nightmare. I mean, really, I mean, you're going to, like you said, you got one side of the cheek that's going to be one shade and the other one's going to be another. It's going to be a nightmare, and you're going to be playing with that, and it's going to be probably really hard to get to look good. I guess you could make it a black and white and take care of it that way, but yeah. But you know what I mean, if you're going for the color.
Some of these get expensive. I mean, you think that you're taking, instead of getting flash because you're afraid of, you don't see the modeling light, you don't know what you're getting, although you can see the LCD screen on the back of the camera. But they'll put these in clusters, and so you might have five or six in a softbox. But it's still coming up to, 800 or 900 watts, but it's watts is based on an hour. It's not like having an 800 or a 400 watt flash.
Right. And the other thing that I think we got to point out too, though, Joe, because, people are thinking, okay, I'm going to get this and I'm going to save some money, right? I can go to Home Depot or one of these places and just get a bunch of these lights and string them together. Or I can, get a cluster and make my own cluster or whatever. I've seen videos and stuff on YouTube where people are making their homemade lights and they're using those things and they're putting like four or five of them together. The problem is you're going to do all this stuff and you're probably still going to spend $100, $150 for this stuff. And personally, you can go and get an Alien B, 160 watt strobe and an umbrella for probably under $300. And that's the professional way. That's the, to me personally, I mean, again, let's just reiterate, these are our opinions. All right. We've been doing it. We have our own opinions, but it's from experience. And Joe has a lot more than I do, and he's played around with all kinds of lights. But, you're not going to really save that much time or that much money in the end. What you are going to do is you're going to probably waste a lot of time because you're going to be trying to correct it and post-edit, and you're going to wonder why you're having more problems trying to get this thing right. So I guess what we're saying is we would go with a strobe. Now, if you already have some, continuous lights and you want to play with them, just make sure that you keep using all continuous. Don't mix and match because then it will be a nightmare. But other than that, I think we got a roll here, Joe. Anything else you want to add real quick so we can get these guys going so they can either play with the lights that they have or go out and get the ones that they need?
No, just learn to use lighting, whether it's continuous or flash, and make it your friend and play with it.
Yeah, just experiment. That's really how you're going to learn the best. Experiment and play with some settings. And like I said, if you're out there and you're using the continuous, just make sure that you use all continuous. And if you're using flash, make sure you stay with all flash. And that's it. That's going to wrap up this podcast. And we will talk to everyone real soon. And again, keep the questions coming in because we really do. We really like reading them. Number one, and number two, it gives us more stuff to talk about in the next podcast. So that's it. That's going to wrap it up. We will talk to you later. And happy shooting. We'll